Okay, in this video I'm going to show you how to connect your Windows computer to the Okapi systems. I actually have three different Okapi systems I'm going to connect concurrently or simultaneously here today. Some of the instructions might be a little rushed or complicated, so feel free to pause the video at any time. Okay, so first of all, we go into the control panel, and then you want to look for View Devices and Printers. Once that's loaded up, you locate Add a Device at the top here and click on that. It's now searching for the devices automatically. Okay, you can see it's come up with three ABBTM modules. So we are going to click on those and click Next in turn. And for each device, it'll request a passcode. The passcode is always 0000. And click Next. Okay, now we're going to add the second Okapi system. Again, just select the ABBTM module and click Next. 0000. And finally, we're going to add the third Okapi system. So, ABBTM, next. Passcode is 0000. And there we go. Now we can see all three Okapi systems listed in the device manager. Now we don't know which is which, but we're going to find that out in a moment when we use the Okapi viewer. So for each of the ABBTM modules, we now have to find out which communications port it's associated with. So for this first one, I'm going to right-click, go to Properties, click on the Services tab, and we see this is COM port 4, so I'm going to make a note of that, COM port 4, click OK, second device, Properties, Services, COM port 5, and the third device, right-click, Properties, Services, and that's COM port 7. Okay, so now we are going to load up the Okapi viewer. Actually, let me just show you where to get that from. So this is our website, greenhillenvirotechnologies.com. If you go to the Okapi viewer app tab, click on that, and this gives you the instructions about where to get the app from and how to download it. If you don't have the Java runtime environment installed on your machine, you'll need to go to oracle.com. Go ahead and click the link here. Be careful with other links because they might include malware, but this link is directly to Oracle, the manufacturer of the software. And then you'll have to just make sure that you get the correct version of Java runtime environment for your machine. So if you have a 64-bit Windows system, just ensure that you get the 64-bit version of JRE. If you have a 32-bit Windows operating system, make sure you get the x86 version, which is the 32-bit version. And the Okapi app is up on sourceforge.net currently, and the link again is on this website. And you want to click on the Okapi viewer.jar, and that will download the application, which again needs the Java runtime environment to operate correctly. Okay, so once you've done all that and you've located your Okapi Java app, we have it on the desktop here, and it has some files associated with it. It's already been running, and these files are actually logs from our own solar heaters. So we're just going to launch Okapi Viewer. That's once. I'm going to launch it three times here. Two and three. So now we have closed the control panel, minimize that. We now have three instances of the Okapi viewer, and this one's already got COM port 4 in there, which it's loaded up from the previous settings. So I'm going to go ahead and click connect. Okay, so that tells me straight away this is the Okapi T-Sense. It's also given me the serial number. So if we have more than one T-Sense connected, we can identify which is which by the serial number, which will be unique for each Okapi. Now we're going to go to COM port 5 from our list. We previously noted the list of COM ports. Click connect. Okay, and this is an Okapi 2 system, so we see values for two different heaters, the ambient temperature. Again, because this is a full Okapi system, we have the fan speeds. The fans are not currently running. The Okapi T-Sense does not have the fan information. It's just five temperature sensors. And finally, we're going to connect to the third system. That's on COM port 7. Okay, and this just has Okapi listed. And that's pretty much it. So the serial number is just a development serial number there, FFFF. Otherwise, you just see the values for one heater. Okay, and that really concludes how to connect your Okapi systems. It's pretty straightforward. How to connect your Okapi systems to a Windows-based operating system. All right, thanks for watching, and have a great day.
Next generation.